Your brain is you. An intricate maze of neurons and connections holds every thought and feeling you've ever had. The way you move, past loves and future dreams. It's everything, and yet it is generally still a mystery. We peer into the brain to gain a deeper understanding using an array of imaging devices. You may have heard of a few: MRI, PET, and CT scans. Magnetoencephalography, or MEG, supplements these techniques by providing real-time measurements of brain activity, so researchers and doctors can see what's happening in the brain as it happens. When you think or act or feel, your neurons fire, creating pulses of electric currents. These currents, in turn, generate weak magnetic fields. MEG works by detecting these magnetic fields. An MEG machine houses a helmet lined with 306 very sensitive sensors, or SQUID devices, which record the location and intensity of these magnetic fields. This millisecond by millisecond information is fed back to the magnetoencephalographer, who is able to interpret the significance of the brain's electric signals. This millisecond precision data can help doctors make informed decisions as to what's actually happening in your brain. When combined with other techniques that allow for an image of the brain to be built, such as MRI, they can decipher when and where neurons are firing, just like listening into or eavesdropping on a conversation between different parts of the brain. The use of MEG, together with other diagnostic imaging modalities, provide more time-sensitive information. MEG is an incredibly useful and more direct, yet non-invasive tool for clinicians trying to understand why the brain is not working normally in a patient. If you think of the brain being like the electric grid and the electricity becomes visible, MEG gives an indication of where electricity is flowing normally, or where there are broken connections. In the brains of epileptic patients, for instance, it would show flashing sparks where abnormal activity takes place. Besides identifying areas of the brain responsible for epileptic patient seizures, MEG is sometimes also used to localize brain functions for sensory processing or motor control, as well as complex tasks such as language. This makes it a powerful tool in pre-surgical planning. Don't just take our word for it. When Alyssa was 5 years old, she had a seizure-inducing tumor close to her speech center. Surgery was required, but due to the location of the tumor, there was a real risk of her speech function being affected. In conjunction with MRI, MEG was used to both find how the tumor was causing seizures and also to confirm the position of her speech areas. A 1 centimeter margin for the safe removal of the tumor was found, and Alyssa walked out of the hospital tumor-free a few days later, with her speech unaffected. MEG is also used in research into traumatic brain injuries, dementias, and autism spectrum disorders, as well as in many other neurological and psychiatric conditions. It is also extensively used to study normal brain function. Researchers are studying, for example, changes in the networks of activity within and between different areas of the brain to predict the risk of disease such as dementia or to identify children affected by autism. Magnetoencephalography is an exciting technique that is already showing real potential and helps us understand how the brain works in real time to improve the lives of patients affected by neurological or psychiatric disorders.